movie that's well known is the soundtrack. The soundtrack was put together by Cat Stevens. He did all of the songs for it. Obviously, these are favorites, so these are all movies that I would recommend people seeing if they haven't. So I won't say recommended after each one. Just know that I love them all. Next is one that I bet will be the most familiar movie of all of these.
Response of the premiere
audience in 1939, and the original negative was destroyed during World War II. It wasn't reconstructed until 1959. That version, which has stunned viewers for decades, is presented here. I think it's so good. It's funny, as it says. It's a comedy of manners, but it's also scathing. It's very much a, it's very much an editorial on the people that it's showcasing in the movie. Again, it has a nice little book that just has lots of details about the movie. actually has two, the film and then the supplements. So it had so many extras, it needed its own extra disc. And then there's a third disc, that is the Blu-ray. So this is more of a nice set. Again, here you can see the book, which is really nice. So there's the characters, there's Jules and Jim, and there's the woman that comes between them, shall we say. Some other planet. from 1936. This is the movie that introduced my husband and I to screwball comedies. A long time ago, we used to go rent movies at Hollywood Video, RIP Hollywood Video, and this is one that we rented and just fell in love with it. And after that, you know, we searched out as many screwball comedies as we can. If anyone's interested in my list of top screwball comedies, let me know. And I honestly think I must have missed it on our Criterion shelf, because another one that I love is The Palm Beach Story. And I think we have it on Criterion, but I didn't see it. Maybe I just overlooked it. So that's another really great one too. Let me read this one to you. Oh, here's Carol Lombard again. Carol Lombard and William Powell dazzle in this definitive screwball comedy by Gregory LaCava. A potent cocktail of romantic repartee and social critique, Irene, an eccentric, wealthy Manhattanite, wins a society ball scavenger hunt after finding a forgotten man, an apparent down-and-out drifter at a dump. She gives him work as the family butler and soon falls head over heels for him. Her attempts to both woo Godfrey and indoctrinate him in the household's dysfunction make for a string of madcap hijinks that has never been bested. LaCava's deft film was the first to garner Oscar nominations in all four acting categories, and it is one of Hollywood's greatest commentaries on class and the social unrest of the Depression era. So yeah, William Powell plays a forgotten man who's somebody that was down and out after the Depression, and Carol Lombard is this wealthy socialite who takes him in, and she's just batty and flighty and hilarious, and he becomes their butler, and then it's just about all the hijinks that they get up to. So that's a really neat cover. This would be Carol Lombard and William Powell. Here's part of the scavenger hunt. I like that. Monkey, goat, forgotten man. Return to ballroom no later than midnight. Favorite films of all time. It is a film called Playtime by Jacques Tati. This is also a French film. It's from 1967. We actually have the Criterion Collection sold a whole set of films by Tati, and we have that as well because I love him. He might be my favorite director. He's definitely one of my favorite directors. Center. as it said, it's nearly worthless. It actually is mostly worthless comedy. There are sight gags, there are sound gags, and there are some words. Occasionally people talk, but you're never bored. That sounds boring sometimes without words. It's just absolutely delightful. All of his films are, I love them all.
Much in them.
This one's just a fold out. There is a picture there. This is Monsieur Hugo. He also did something in his films called False Hulots, where he would have various people in the film dressed in it. This is Monsieur Hulot's standard outfit, this hat and an umbrella and his trench coat, and he would have people that looked like him in the film, and you would kind of get distracted by this. It's an interesting concept. Yeah, so Criterion Collection films have a number at the bottom, and those are like as the films are released. I think that is the number, the order that they were released in. So you can see this was early. This is 112 versus like His Girl Friday, which is 849. So, you know, this is early on. They've gotten, you know, more spectacular as they went along. All right. Thank you so much for joining me tonight. I hope you enjoyed this little look at some of my favorite films that I have that are Criterion, and really some of my favorite films, period. If you liked this, please awake.